Hey everyone, today we're testing two different 5G home internet options. We're doing the T-Mobile 5G business and the AT&T All-Fi Hub. Let's get into it. All right, so we're gonna compare the speeds to these two devices. I just tested the T-Mobile speed several different times, probably a dozen times. And although I did get different speeds on the laptop than I did on the phone, they are pretty consistent per device. And the speeds that we were seeing on the phone are close to 600 megabits a second down, and then about 100 megabits a second up. But you know, on the low end, 83 up, and then on the low end, on the down speed, it's like, you know, still like 400 and something. So pretty consistent speeds. So right now I'm going to switch my Wi-Fi over to connect to the AT&T All-Fi Hub. So now we're connected to the AT&T All-Fi Hub, and we're gonna rip some speed tests using speedtest.net, and it's gonna connect to whatever server it thinks it's closer. Already I can tell that the ping speed on the AT&T All-Fi Hub is way slower than what I was seeing on T-Mobile just a moment ago. On the T-Mobile, I was seeing ping speeds around 24, 25, sometimes 17 milliseconds. And it looks like we're seeing ping speeds of 86 so far on the AT&T All-Fi Hub. And again, that's connecting to the same server. So we just saw 343 down and 20 up, which is honestly, that's what I've been seeing pretty consistently on the All-Fi Hub. I've had it for 7 months now, and that's just kind of the speeds that I can expect. I would say that it can get a little bit faster. It is 6 o'clock on a Sunday, I'm sorry, 6 o'clock on a Saturday evening right now, and so that's part of the issue that I'm running into with the AT&T is during peak times, because it is broadband, I'm sharing the internet with so many other people around here, and it does get slower. I did not experience slow speeds just now at the same time on the T-Mobile device. So we're gonna do four or five tests on the AT&T right now, just rip through them and just see what we can come up with. So 311 down, ping of 60 milliseconds and 23 up. Okay, we're gonna test it again, boop. Okay, so pretty consistent here. Now we're seeing 58 ping, 300 down and 24 up. Like I said, Very consistent. And we're gonna run a couple more tests and then we will take a look at the results, all of them, and see what you think. So here we are, 63 ping, 63 milliseconds, and download speed is 340 megabits a second, and upload is gonna be kind of what it was again, you know, right around the low 20s, 23 this time. So that's great. Let's take a look at all the results. So right here, you can see if you look at the phone, the last one, two, three, four tests were all on AT&T. And then the one, two, three, four prior to that were all on T-Mobile. And you can see right here, clear as day, that one is definitely faster. And I'm really impressed. I am. I didn't expect the speeds to be this fast with T-Mobile. It's way faster than what they advertised. I don't know if I'm getting special treatment because this is the business plan. I wasn't able to get the home edition. I think if the device is the same and the network is the same, I don't know if there's like different prioritization, but I'm really impressed. Out of the three 5G home internet providers that I've had and tested, this T-Mobile device is by far the fastest, by far. The AT&T is the second fastest, but probably the least consistent. And I did have the Verizon for a while, and the service on the Verizon was very consistent. I never had to mess with the device. I never had to think about it. It was a smaller device than either of these, and it just worked, but it just wasn't quite fast enough for me. And so I upgraded to the AT&T, and it was faster upload speeds. Besides that, I'm not impressed. This box is huge. And you know, if you like it, that's great, but it's harder to find a place that it goes. I noticed it's sensitive to heat. On a hotter day, when it's hotter in the house here, you know, it has an internal fan that spins up, but the internet just stops. And so we have to reset it on warmer days. And we're not in the desert, it's not 100 degrees. You know, it can be 80 degrees outside and the device gets too hot and I have to reset it. So that's my quick review on the AT&T All-Fi Hub. And you know, obviously I don't want to pay for two devices, so I'm going to hang on to this one for another billing cycle or at least another 2 weeks before I trade it in, just to make sure that I'm gonna get consistent quality and consistent speed from a T-Mobile device. So before you all comment down below, a couple of things. Yes, I know I could get a faster signal if I put these right up into the window. My problem is I don't have a window that I can put it right up against, so I don't. And this is a side-by-side comparison. This is real world. They are right next to each other. And if I aim them different directions and things like that, I could maybe get faster speed or slower speed out of either one. I have moved the AT&T device around and faced it in different places and put it by windows. And I've even tried it outside and different things. And the biggest speed changes that I've seen are less than 10%. And so maybe my house doesn't have very thick walls and it isn't super impacted by not being in front of a window. I'm not sure, but your device may vary as well. We're in a rural area. I'm on a 15-acre farm with a river behind me on one side, and my home is elevated up. And so there really aren't even any trees because it's all farmland between me and the server. So the height thing for me, I don't think it's going to make a big difference. But if you've got a lot of trees in the yard and in the neighborhood, it could make a big difference for you. And if you have a house with, you know, nice thick insulated walls, or anything with metal, or if you're in an apartment building with thick commercial walls, get by a window and see if that makes a difference with your speeds. Also, when you're doing speed tests, it's important to get accurate speed tests by making sure that only the device that you're testing with is connected to the Wi-Fi on whatever device you happen to be testing. Because if somebody's downloading something or a TV is doing an update in the background and you don't know about it, that's gonna affect your speed. Today we did a showdown between the T-Mobile 5G business device and the AT&T All-Fi Hub, and the clear winner in every category, response time, upload speed, and download speed, is the T-Mobile device. Thanks for tuning in. If you have similar devices or if you have a different brand that you'd like to share the results, make sure that you comment down below. I always want to get the fastest internet that I can, especially because I'm uploading huge video files all the time, and I love hearing from everyone. Let's keep the community growing. And if you got anything from this video, like and subscribe. Thanks so much and have a good one.